I think, you know, the whole global community has realized that our carbon dioxide into the atmosphere is causing a problem. And trying to reduce that as aggressively as we can, really to prevent things like global warming, is really the purpose behind the whole carbon management discussion.
Whether a company talks to their customers, whether they talk to their employees, whether they talk to their investors, right? I think across the board now there's a wide acceptance that climate change is an issue that we all need to work together to solve.
So carbon management is a holistic approach to look at where is carbon wanted and where it is not wanted. It is wanted in our daily lives in terms of consumer products that we have in there, in terms of hydrocarbons, where they are converted into plastics, into all kinds of things that live and we have every day. Like this chair, there's a lot of carbon in that chair that I'm sitting on. We do not want carbon in the form of carbon dioxide or methane in our atmosphere.
You can see temperatures rising, you can see CO2 growing in the atmosphere, and it's a clear issue that all of humanity needs to be focused on. Our goal with carbon management is to realize we need to, on our way to net zero, work down that curve. So we need to be focusing on how to take these incremental CO2 reductions to get from today, where too much CO2 is emitted, to the future where ideally no CO2 is being emitted.
So there's a collective conversation about how to go about doing this cost effectively, efficiently, and as quickly as possible. You know, I think it starts with, you know, just take a look at what we did with nutrition. We started reading labels, right? And we understood what was happening with what we were consuming. It's very similar with carbon management. We have to look at the carbon footprint of everything that we're doing, everything we're consuming.
I think, you know, that we have as a society kind of taken advantage of the fact that in first world countries, we have access to anything that we can afford, right? And we don't really spend a lot of time thinking about the energy footprint of those items. And we don't really think about it because we don't think about the individual, you know, our cell phone and our refrigerator and the air conditioning that we in Houston love to crank down to 67 to keep the house feeling perfectly cool and dehumidified. But those things are additive.
There's many small changes that we can make in our personal life. And it all boils down to the throwaway culture that we've unfortunately inherited. And the best recycle is our own personal recycle.
You know, am I using my thermostat correctly at home and not, you know, using too much air conditioning or too little? Am I moving to electricity that's solar generated? You know, these are some of the simple footsteps as consumers we can make. As individuals, we can take a look at those type of actions and make those decisions ourselves in order to reduce our personal carbon footprint.
Really, when a company thinks about their carbon management plan, they need to think about emissions from all of these sources and think about what are the easiest to control, right? What are the highest volume of carbon emissions that we have when you look at all the things that we do as a company, and then which of those are controllable?
Carbon management includes three important steps: assessment, optimization, and innovation. What you don't measure, you can't manage. And this is especially important because many customers are challenged by the reality that they have yet to assess their total emissions.
I think they have to understand where their carbon emissions are coming from, right? We have to look at direct, indirect, and, you know, scope 1, scope 2, scope 3 benefits, and really get a catalog of where those emissions are coming from. Then it's, how do I reduce them? And of course, you're going to start with the largest sources first. Can I do efficiency gains in order to reduce the carbon footprint by renewables, or capture some of that carbon dioxide and sequester it? You know, one of the common products that can be made from CO2 is combining it with hydrogen and making methanol. Methanol can be a fuel. Methanol can be a building block to more advanced chemicals. We can use CO2 in order to make concrete. which is actually the opposite of what happens today. Today, when we make concrete, CO2 emissions are incredibly high. It's one of the largest sources of CO2 emissions. There are different types of concrete that are being commercialized now that actually use CO2 as a feed, calcifies it, really uses it as a strength, and that material is actually stronger than concrete is today.
You know, really depends on your own process, and it depends on what your emissions are. For some companies, the easiest thing to do and the most cost-effective thing to do may be to purchase renewable power using a power purchase agreement, right, or PPA. Other companies may have large quantities of highly concentrated CO2 that's easier to capture, and they can capture it themselves and sequester that underground. Other companies may want to transition their fleet of vehicles, distribution vehicles, to either battery electric vehicles or fuel cell vehicles.
You know, a lot happens with your purchasing behavior. If you're buying low carbon intensity products or products that recycle plastics, that's where companies are going to allocate their resources and their energy to produce those products. Advocating with the government around requirements and incentives, these are difficult challenges. They're expensive challenges. Incentives help. They do reward the right behavior. There are some tax credits that are available. Those are expiring. Extending those tax credits and advocating that you want to see those changes take place so that as a society we drive down the cost of sequestering carbon and lowering carbon emissions. Those are good actions for everybody.
We all can make an impact. It takes everybody collectively to do that. There's not a silver bullet that's going to fix the greenhouse gas emissions, right, and reduce the effect of climate change. We all have to participate in that.